This is a question from production for 1 mark. Each of 6 mm thickness are to be butt welded. Consider the following processes and select the correct sequence in increasing order of size of heat affected zone. Arc welding, MIG welding, laser beam welding and submerged arc welding. These are the 4 processes given to us and we need to find out the increasing order of heat affected zones for these 4 processes. When you look at the options, it can be observed that option D is the correct answer according to the official key. Okay, let's move on to the solution. Among these 4 processes, the first process which has the least heat affected zone will be laser beam welding, because laser beam welding generally uses a focused beam for welding process to carry out. Okay, also since it uses a focused beam, it has high heat input, so the total heat content will be low and thus the heat affected zones will be small. The next process which comes out in the order is MIG welding or metal inert gas welding. Since this process uses an inert gas atmosphere to protect the welding pool from the atmospheric contamination, its heat affected zone will be less, but it will be greater than the laser beam welding. The next process which comes in the order is submerged arc welding. This submerged arc welding process generally uses a blanket of flux. Throughout the welding process, the welding takes place under the blanket of flux. So, the heat affected zone will be also less in this process, but it will be greater than MIG welding as well as laser beam welding. The last process which has the highest heat affected zone among these 4 processes is arc welding process. Since arc welding process is carried out open to atmosphere, and since it has the low heat input, it indicates that the total heat content will be high and the heat affected zones will be high. So therefore, the process is the increasing order of the size of heat affected zones among these 4 processes is, first process will be laser beam welding, followed by MIG welding, followed by submerged arc welding, followed by arc welding.